What does speak truth to power mean to you?
There are moments in history, in the history of any country, when the most radical, revolutionary public service that you can do is to speak the truth. And I think that particularly we are living at one such moment in India's history, where whatever else you do, the importance of speaking truth and speaking truth fearlessly, whatever happens, has become very important, but also very difficult. And just a little bit about why I feel this moment has become so difficult. On the one hand, we're seeing, particularly after this, the second election of this government, at a time when the economy is in such bad shape, where there was very little else on offer truly this time, unlike in 2014, where there was an expectation of jobs, of improvement of the economy, this time what was really on offer was muscular, nationalist, Hindutva, oriented hate, and the fact that the government got an even larger backing this time, I feel that they're acting as though they have a clear mandate now to implement the idea of the Hindu Rashtra. And they have identified three major enemies. One, I would say the first enemy is the morality of the constitution. Not just the letter of the constitution, but that it stood for a country which belonged equally to people of every faith and identity. It was a country where justice, liberty, equality, fraternity, etc. The second enemy is the Indian Muslim. And there is an open declaration of war in many ways. So, you know, and over the next couple of years, we're going to see, we've seen 370, we're going to see the Ayodhya temple, we're going to see the Citizenship Amendment Act, which will actually alter India's secular constitution, which means only Muslims within India will have to prove their citizenship on the basis of documents, everybody else is okay, and a national NRC, and so on. So that is, and the third enemy is those who stand in defense of the constitution and of India's religious minorities, and which is the dissenter or the voices of conscience. And I see much more clearly than in the last 5 years an all-out assault on all of these three. And in these times, therefore, speaking truth to power at all costs becomes our highest duty.
You know, we also have Kanak, you know, Harsh, you said that this is possibly in India, but I would reckon, you know, there is a thought which suggests that there is a rise of majoritarian politics across the country, across the world. And Kanak comes from Nepal, and you yourself, you know, you've been arrested, your paper has been shut down, it's restarted now. How would you read speaking truth to power in the current context?
Well, I would like to bring the South Asian perspective, coming myself from Kathmandu. And I would like to say that one looks at India askance for how much it is becoming more like the rest of South Asia. That is a major danger that everybody has thought of India as the exemplar for democracy, for freedom of expression, freedom of assembly, all the fundamental rights. And while India may have made mistakes along the way, the ideal was always to be emulated. Mm-hmm. And that is where I believe India has slipped. As a result, the topic of the day being speaking truth to power, looking at each of our societies is extremely weakened. But the society that we thought would stand firm was India. That's why, responding to your question, I would say speaking truth to power is more and more difficult all over South Asia. There is self-censorship because of intimidation of the opinion makers and journalists all over South Asia. There is social media populism all over South Asia. There is state autocracy. There is majoritarian radical populism, as I call it. So for that reason, the journalists and the writers and the opinion makers are intimidated.